Truly, if smell-o-vision was happening, you would be loving it so, so much. Our kitchen smells so fresh and amazing with Chef Paulette here.
Oh my goodness. Yay. Okay, so you're doing little hand pies.
Yes, I love little things. I don't know why I get attracted to that. No. Because it's more work in the kitchen because you have to make so many, and usually it's
but
you
if you're
one
doing
one.
A Super Bowl party, for
yes,
example,
this would be very nice.
These are perfect. Yeah.
Or you and just like that 3 o'clock coffee with a tasty, tasty.
Oh, come on now, that's what I'm
I
talking
do that
about.
A lot. Do
oh.
that a lot. And okay. you know, I've made these kind of ham pies before with mascarpone and berries and stuff like that.
Okay.
And then I'm thinking, okay, it's winter time, so berries, meh. Oranges.
Yeah, it's the season for oranges.
You know, I actually looked online saying, well, somebody must have made a pie with oranges. I couldn't find one.
Really?
So,
okay. So you made one yourself.
So I made this up. Okay.
I like it.
So I'm going to just get into this spot
right
here.
Yes, of course.
So
I'll get into this spot right here.
Okay.
How about that?
This is the mixture. It's mascarpone
okay.
with oranges cut up, fresh oranges cut up in
okay.
there. There's
here,
some sugar.
Hold on, we have a little camera shot.
Okay.
There it is. Perfect.
There is some
sugar.
See how
sugar. You put the oranges in there?
I love it.
That's amazing.
Did you do a lot of sugar, just like a little?
You know, I think it's too much sugar. It's
okay.
a third of a cup. It's kind of borderline for me because
okay.
I'm not that sweet.
So maybe
but
a fourth instead of a third.
Yeah, yeah maybe, well. You know, play with it.
Okay.
See what you
see
like.
What you like.
Test it out.
I
right.
want to show you something. This is how I cut the orange to get
all
those
right.
pieces.
So you did
now,
a little
first
zest.
I zest it.
Okay.
You would zest this whole thing.
I
but
it.
I cut off each end like this.
This is a master
and then
class right now.
Come around like this.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and get all of the white pith off because you don't want any of that stuff.
Mm-mm.
And then once you have your nice clean orange, you can cut it into circles and then cut it into dice.
Mm.
And that's kind of what I do. I just cut these like this and then cut these into smaller pieces. And you can put the whole thing in there so you don't have to worry about the white bitter part. Okay?
Right.
So the zest and the orange goes in there with the sugar.
Okay.
Okay, now puff pastry.
Yep. Perfect amount of sugar,
from
by the
way. Store.
Delicious.
Oh, okay, good.
Delicious. Okay.
For me, sometimes I go, I'm not sure.
Mm.
So I have like a square cutter. You can do this round. I just cut it like this.
Okay.
Okay. And then you take a few, a little bit, more than you think, because it doesn't, when you close it, it comes
more than
gushing
you think.
Out. No, I'm sorry. Less,
less
than you,
than
think.
You think. Okay.
Less than you think. Because then when you close it, it'll come squishing
this
out.
This is the part I really
want
to watch when
much.
You close.
Okay.
All right.
So then just get into your ends and get them down. I see I did put too much.
That's all right. You
but
can lick
you
it
know
up
what?
Your finger.
This still works. I've had done it like this and it works. Then you take a fork.
Okay.
And you.
Oh, you do the little edges.
This keeps it closed even better.
Did I eat a whole pie? Yes, I did.
It was just a little
right.
hand pie.
They're a little hand pie, so I didn't feel guilty about it.
That's
it's
right.
So
you
delightful.
Can have three, and it's still not
okay,
a piece.
So you've got this
can
on
you
your
try this while you're
little egg
it.
Wash.
Okay.
And then you bake that for about, I don't know, 20, 25 minutes. I'm
okay.
so bad with time. I just look in the oven and go, okay, it's done.
You know what? This
because
is
she's
perfect.
A real chef.
This is well, and this is perfect for the Italian cooking because truly, isn't that how Italians work? They talk about kind of feeling your way
that's
through a
right.
recipe
there's
instead of...
That's right. There's that phrase, quanto basta. So quanto means
basta.
How much, basta means enough.
Enough.
So how long should be in the oven? How long is enough?
Enough.
How much is
that's
enough?
That's amazing.
Is enough? Okay,
whoa.
Here's our vanilla drizzly glaze.
Now, what is
so,
this? Is this cream?
Simple. So simple, a tablespoon of soft butter, room temperature butter,
okay.
about a half cup of powdered sugar,
okay.
a little bit of vanilla, and then hot, hot water.
Oh.
And you keep stirring, stirring, stirring until you put
a
little bit of water at a time and
okay.
you get that.
All right,
so
we're just
now
drizzle.
Drizzle this over. And then we have our crushed walnuts that goes on top.
Oh, yes, that's
and
what I was tasting.
My
yeah,
walnut
can we talk
crusher.
About your device
this
here? This is amazing.
That's
so you put
cute.
The walnuts in the top. Like
Carol
this.
And I like a kitchen gadget,
and
that's
then
for sure.
You just
it's true.
Turn it like a jack-in-the-box.
Oh!
And the walnuts come out crushed.
But nothing
there.
Pops and scares you
no.
like a jack-in-the-box.
And it
I
even has
that.
Like this little measurement thing on here somewhere
this
so you
is
know how much
beautiful.
You have.
Guys, this is such a really, really nice recipe. We're going to put
it's
it
so
on our
easy,
website.
Because when you buy the dough, okay, you can make the dough and that's easy too, I
no.
think. But this puff like pastry is really nice. This is a nice brand, actually. I love this one.
Well,
what's your
really
brand?
Good. Well, Trader Joe.
I knew you were going to say Trader Joe.